Hey guys, Christine Holly here for Hollywood First Look Features. We're here on the black carpet for Starz's new show, American Gods. Let's not waste any more time and hit the black carpet. How is it playing Mr. Nancy?
It's fun. He's tricky, quite shifty, and I love the role.
What made you so intrigued to play the role?
You know, I've been hearing stories about Anansi, the spider god, stealing the stories from the sky god since I was a little kid. So to actually play a role that, you know, came from, African culture and made its way through the Middle Passage, and this tale from Ghana of the Ashanti people is now being done in American Gods in Neil Gaiman's version, is pretty amazing.
Tell us about American Gods.
American Gods is about, you know what, there's been a lot of things written already, and I continue to say this. None of the hype will prepare you for what you're about to see. This is really like the kind of, well, first of all, the novel itself was unbelievable. I'd read it years ago. And then to finally see it come to life, it really is, it's something fantastical and wonderful, and I'm glad to be a part of it.
Tell us a little bit about the character you play in American Gods.
Well, my character is Ifrit, who's a djinn, who drives a cab. You know, he's a pre-Islamic god, spiritual, how can I put it? In the Quran it says that there was three beings that God made. He made people of clay, people of fire, and people of light. So you have the angels, you have the humans, and then you have the people of fire, which are the djinn. And djinns are creatures that in the Islamic religion, where we can't see them, but they could see us. They could be part of our world. They're neither good or bad. They're just like us.
Tell us about the character that you play.
So I play Salim, who's an immigrant from Oman. And he's been in America for a week. And he very much is self-loathing and doesn't love himself very much because he's gay, he's Muslim. Which is, you know, a contradiction in itself. And then he comes and he takes a taxi ride that's not your mother's taxi ride, and he meets the djinn, and they have a connection, and then he experiences what godlike energy.
Who is Matt Sweeney?
Matt Sweeney is a leprechaun who likes to fight and talk dirty and be mean to people, basically.
How does a tall guy like you play a leprechaun?
Well, it was in the description, you know. In the novel, he's described as 7 feet tall. I don't quite get there. I'm 6'5", but they figured why not? Let the short guy have a shot.
I like the suit.
Well, I play a prisoner for the most part in American Gods, so if I'm coming out for the premiere here on Sunset Boulevard in Hollywood, California, I better look good.
And tell us who you play.
I play Loki Lysmith. Loki is he's the reliable narrator with a very unconventional method. I'm very mischievous.
Yeah.
I have quite a bit I dance quite a bit with our lead character, Ricky Whittle's Shadow Moon, in prison, and I give him a lot of advice to help him as his journey continues. But you're not quite sure how reliable it is until it pans out that I end up saving him a few times in the pilot episode of the show.
Hey guys, make sure you guys check out American Gods when it is on Starz. This is Christine Holly for Hollywood First Look Features. I'll see you guys next time.
What's a god? They're real if you believe in them.
So who are you?
You wouldn't believe in me if I told you.
This is my man, Shadow Moon.
He does not know our world.
I'm easing him in.
You've gotten yourself mixed up in some really weird shadow. You think I'm spent?
You're as forgotten and as unloved as any of us.
I'm doing just fine.
You trying to start a war?
We're at war already, and we're losing.
Who's after you?
Times, they are changing.
We need you to fight them, to show them who we are.
They are gods, for God's sake!
So what's the plan?
War.
Deliver me. Deliver me.
None of this feels real. It feels like a dream.
Things are never going back to the way that they were.
It will be glorious, win or lose.
Deliver me.